Get Sports Focus is presented by Dr. Ting Sports Medicine and Orthopedic Surgery.
Hey, Get Sports Focus, it's Allie Williams, and today the matchups have been set for NorCal's Valley Christian as their opponent. But for now, we get one of the top linemen in the league and very recent CCS champion, Mr. Dylan McCreary. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you, it's good to be here.
Yeah, you know, you've had a week as CCS champs. How was that week for you guys?
It's kind of surreal. Yeah, it didn't set in until maybe 3 or 4 days after. I was just sitting at home and, you know, we got the hardware, we got it done. We've been saying it for the past 2 years is what we wanted to do. We knew we had the team to do it, so it's a surreal feeling. It's nice to have one on our finger.
Yeah. Congratulations, and you had some tough competition to get there, definitely. And during the season, you had a lot to prepare yourselves for that, and including you had to beat Sarah, you had a win over Mitty in double overtime.
Yeah.
And then you had a real close loss to St. Francis. So can you go over those games and how you think that they kind of prepped you for the playoffs?
I mean, yeah, you know, we played our preseason. We went up, our last game was against Pleasant Valley. We knew we had to play good, played pretty well, won the game with a game-winning field goal. And, you know, we knew Sarah was it last year. They kind of smacked us around a little bit. They embarrassed us. So we wanted revenge. We knew what we had to do. Came out, great week of practice. Got the job done, 35-28, and then midi game, you know, we came out a little flat. We didn't expect them to, you know, play as well as they did. I mean, they had the best game of their lives, in my opinion, but, you know, great teams find ways to win. We rallied around each other and our coach and, you know, got it done, so it was good. And the St. Francis game, you know, we knew, you know, everybody, you guys knew, we knew, the whole CCS knew that was going to be the game to watch all season long, and, It was interesting. The week of practice, there was a lot of pressure put onto ourselves. I know I had a lot of pressure put on me, from me. So, you know, going to that game, we were excited. Warm-ups were good. Everything was great. And we just, you know, they played better than we did that night, and we came up short. But end result is we have a ring, and that's all that we can really be happy for. So.
Well, you able to take some lessons from each game, move forward from there. We see how it left you guys.
Yeah.
And your job on the field is intense. You don't always show up in the box score the way your quarterback, receiver, all that goes. But you have a big part in the reason why they end up in the box score.
Yeah.
And do you think the offensive line, do you guys have the most underappreciated job on the field? We can say one of the most if you don't want to offend anyone.
I mean, like universally, yeah, the O-line doesn't get a lot of credit. But I mean, on our team specifically, whenever we score a touchdown, you know, quarterback miles, runs, or throws one, the glory is given to us, whether it's on the field or on the sideline. We still get yelled at the most in film room, but, you know, everybody has a role. We know what we got to do, and everybody's grateful for each other. We know we couldn't get the job done without each other, so it's nice.
Yeah, what about that offensive line? I mean, the season you guys have had, that certainly helps, but you guys must be a pretty close Nick group. What is it like working with your team?
Oh, yeah, you know, I mean, it's great. We've been together all 4 years since freshman year. We knew we were going to be something special. Coming up with Coach Stoney, one of the best offensive line coaches in CCS, probably the state of California. Have a great personal relationship. We all do. You know, we all go eat after the games. You know, Saturday when we watch film, we go have breakfast together, and we're just a tight-knit group. I mean, there's always fights and stuff, but We band together and find a way to win. I mean, I said it last year. I'll say it again this year. We're the best offensive line in CCS. So I'll stick by that. I think it's the truth. And with them, we can do anything. So I'm excited.
Any of that we don't ever see on the field. So you guys do a good job of squashing it before you get on there.
Yeah.
Moving forward, you know, before we go into the future, we have a couple of things to look forward to, but looking back in the spring, you also play shot put.
Yeah.
And you just started a year and a half ago, is that right?
Yeah. I started my sophomore year.
Yeah, and so you started the sophomore year, and then fast forward a year and a half, and you're the WCAL League champ.
Yeah.
Is that correct?
It's crazy. Our defensive line coach, Coach Roll, is our shot put coach, and you know, he brought me out sophomore year, you know, he saw some things, we changed some things. He really said I could be great, and I didn't really buy into it until the very first meet of my last year. I threw like 47 feet, and I was like, okay, it's on. So, you know, it was a long haul. I knew I had some competition going into it, but you know, I worked my butt off each and every day, and I got the job done. So, sweet.
Well, congratulations on that. Just another kind of
another ring. Accolade.
Yeah,
it's nice.
It's been a good run so far. And then looking forward, you guys aren't done this year for your football team. You guys are facing Cardinal Newman moving forward.
Yes.
The bracket, the matchups just came out, so not a lot of time to prepare, but. What are you guys excited about? What do you guys feel that you are going to bring? And what do you know about Cardinal Newman?
You know, we know they're a good team. To make it to a NorCal championship, you have to be good. It's not by accident you show up. But we know, you know, this bye week, we're just talking, you know, we're going to come out harder than we ever have. Be mentally prepared and physically prepared. We're rested up. We know what we have to do. And, you know, we're just going to go out and play our game. Prepare like we do every single week. And we're going to go get the job done.
Look forward to it. It's going to be this Friday at Valley.
So yep, be there.
Got to be there. But and then finally, senior year means recruiting, of course. You just got your first D1 offer from Stetson a few weeks back. Congratulations on
Thank
that.
Thank you.
What goes into the recruiting process for you?
You know, it's a lot of work. You got to put a lot of stuff on tape. You got to make sure your highlight tape is, like, superb. And you have to constantly send it out to every coach you can think of. Try to get their numbers, text them, call them, email them, even if they don't respond to you sometimes because you know they're busy. You just have to keep kind of being a nuisance in their life, try to put your name out there. But, you know, it's kind of slow and steady right now. But really, I mean, I'm just focused on us, you know, trying to win a state ring. So I'm excited for what the future holds, but the present's even better right now. So,
well, finally, kind of on that topic, what do you – you're such an important part of this offensive line at Valley Christian. What do you think that you've brought to Valley, and what do you think it's given back to you?
You know, I just think I've brought a leadership role, more or less. You know, I mean, people say I'm good. I mean, I have bad games, I have good games. But one thing that I try to stay up on and just be a good role model to the guys, you know, I mean, things don't always go our way. We've seen that throughout the season, but If a leader's down on the team, it's going to kind of just drag the team down. So I try to keep myself up and just portray myself to be the better man and, you know, just lead the guys to victory. And, you know, Valley's just given me so much. They've given me more than I could ever, you know, want. A great education, a CCS ring, you know, great coaches. I've made a lot of brotherhood memories and stuff. So, you know, it's just really nice.
Yeah. Well, congratulations on everything you've done
so
far and what you have yet to achieve in your senior year. A big thanks to Dylan McCreary for coming out and joining us today. I want to wish best of luck to Valley Christian as they take on Cardinal Newman. Should be a great game on Friday because it is our game of the week. So we look forward to bringing you those highlights. Dylan, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much.
Good luck this week.
Thank you.